What is going on, guys? This is Jack from Fire and Rice. Just wanted to give you a quick intro to this video. We've done a little bit of post-editing to remove the performances and music from today's episode. We had initially uploaded this video and then it got taken down for a copyright claim. So we did a little bit of editing to remove the videos, but make sure you check out the performances on the American Idol YouTube channel. Link in the description. Without further ado, here's episode 8. Hope you enjoy. Thanks.
Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the Fire and Rice podcast.
What's now, up?
Oh wait, my name is Jack Alvarez.
We do this every time.
That is Jack Alvarez, aka Torchy HD, and we are back with American Idol.
Yes, we are back.
Second to last episode for American Idol.
Yes, that's correct. So we're doing American Idol again on this episode. Just want to quickly start off the show with saying, if you guys haven't seen our Bachelorette episode, we're starting a new TV show commentary review series on The Bachelorette. So if you haven't seen that, definitely go check out our channel. It'll be episode 7.
Yes.
This is episode 8.
Yes.
We didn't mention. This is episode 8.
Right.
Yeah, this is our second to last American Idol recap video.
Yeah.
Pretty sad that it's ending.
I know.
I feel like we just started.
We pretty much just did.
Well, I mean, just like, I don't know. I know that we started our show, our series, you know, a couple episodes into the
right.
actual American Idol. But yeah, it's kind of sad to see it almost come to an end. So, but it is cool
mm-hmm.
because I feel like we have, quote unquote, accomplished something.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So, a win in our books, of course, as long as we get this episode and the next episode out.
Yeah.
Once American Idol is complete, then we can say we've completed our storyline.
Following this season of American Idol. What I noticed is they're calling this season 2
okay.
of American Idol.
Sure.
Rather than season like
whatever
16, 17 or something, because it is on a new network.
I thought that was
interesting.
Yeah. So we'll see. But again, hopefully, if you are excited for the season of Bachelorette, we'll be covering that as well. And of course, if there are any other shows, be sure to let us know in the comments what else we can cover. Because I'm sure it'll be nice to have multiple. It'll be interesting to try to juggle two different series. I've always wanted to see if we could do that. So,
Let's do it.
Yeah, we'll try. Anyway, so let's get started into our weekly recap here. So, this week, we'll be talking a little bit about the top 5 episode with the performances from, we'll call it Bobby's Picks, the Elton John set, as well as the Hero
tributes. Mm-hmm.
So, as a quick recap, our top 5 were Alejandro, Lacey, Lane, Madison, and Wade. So we'll be reviewing performances from them. And we actually have a lot of performances to cover today only because with there being so few contestants, they all performed 3 times.
Yeah.
So a ton of performances in this episode to go through. So I think we should just get right into it.
Yes.
Cool.
Let's do it.
So first up, this section was the first portion of the show. This was Bobby's Picks. And up first, I have the one and only Alejandro singing No Woman, No Cry by Bob Marley. So let's get that up there real quick.
And if you don't know, Bobby Bones is kind of their mentor this season.
Right. Right. That's a good thing to cover.
Yeah. In case I didn't know who Bobby was.
All right. Let's take a listen. Well, what I was trying to say was look at him.
Yes.
Look at him. He's in his, I call it a Hawaiian shirt, whatever you want to call it.
Sure.
Some kind of chill shirt. He's got the chains. It's just him. On the stage, it looks like the guitar.
Uh-huh.
And
it's very reminiscent of his Post Malone cover.
Yeah.
Where it was just him playing the guitar and then the band comes in.
Yeah, and I mean, I just think that this is where Alejandro shines the most. Is when, to me, he feels very much just like a true solo performer that has, you know, a good band to back him up.
Yeah.
And we'll get to this throughout this episode, but I just thought that this performance and the Elton John performance, his best vocally throughout the competition, no doubt. And I don't know, there's just, you said it too, I mean, it's rather than, it's more of like his chest voice that he uses in this song in particular and in the Elton John one. So we'll have to take a listen in for that as it comes up. But I don't know, just super solid performance and a good first.
He's definitely stepping into his star.
Yes.
Into his persona.
Sure.
It was almost as if he was not holding back necessarily, but as if he didn't truly believe that he had a chance of winning this. But I think now that he's in
this
top
far, yeah,
whatever, yeah, he knows that he has a huge chance at taking this whole thing now.
Well, it's crazy because, you know, through following this whole journey, it, like you said, it's like, we said this before, it didn't feel like for a while that he didn't believe in himself.
Yeah, or that he treated this as if it was a competition on national TV. It was as if, I'm just going to go into this, you know, get as much experience as I can, develop my artistry, you know. But yeah, now I think he's looking at it as, I can actually take this if I wanted to.
Sure, right. And it's, and again, I mean, we won't know. We're not inside his mind.
No.
But just this episode in particular, it just felt like he was actually bringing it today and he was actually trying. Mm-hmm. Not to say that he wasn't before.
Yeah, no,
just
no,
like,
no.
There was this new...
I think there's a switch in the mindset a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's a bit more of an awareness as to it's coming to an end.
Yeah, maybe it was that. Maybe it was more so that it was just coming to an end. I definitely think that can kind of kick you
for
into
gear.
So, yeah, Alejandro. I don't know.
Yeah.
More to say about him later on.
Yeah.
Let's move forward. Up next, Lane Hardy. Again, this is still part of Bobby's Picks.
Right.
Can't You See by the Marshall Tucker Band. What do you think about this one?
I think he's bringing the stage presence.
Yeah.
I think he is.
Well, yeah. Go ahead.
But I think what Katie wants is for him to step out of his comfort zone more.
Sure.
Take more risks.
Sure.
Because I think he's a little too in his comfort zone.
Sure. And it's something we brought up over time and time again is like he's getting great song choice.
Yeah.
No doubt. And he's performing it well. It's just, it's too much of consistency, mm-hmm. which isn't a bad thing.
No, it's a really good thing.
But for the sake of the competition,
I think,
you know.
I think people just want something
different
to just,
from him.
You know. I don't know, whether it be good or bad, you know,
a
risk.
Sure. Sure.
Sure.
Well, and that's the thing is, so I think that it's interesting because this performance is almost polar opposite for me from what we just saw with Alejandro in that I mentioned Alejandro was in his element being kind of the front runner, the one man band. I personally like when Lane has more of the band feel and he's part of the band. And, you know, I think when... If you go back a couple performances, there's times where he has maybe the bass or the guitarist up with him at the front of the stage and he can kind of work off with them. But, you know, he does shine more with like full band presence. And but I agree. I think people are it's becoming so consistent, which I think as an artist is a great thing. But when it comes to this show, this competition, yeah, I think you're right. They need to take a little bit of risk, maybe try something a little different or bring something new.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, he did get vocal lessons.
Oh, yeah.
This week. And I thought it showed through.
Oh, yeah. Again.
Or at least in the next couple songs that come about. But so that was a good step. But
I
think maybe. Okay. What do you think would be a surprise or something that he could throw in for the finale?
So that's a tough one. I think, let's see. I don't know. It's tough because it's like...
Hitting the vibrato?
Well, vocally, sure. But I'm just thinking in terms of, like, maybe it's a different song. Maybe it's something not so rock and roll-y.
Okay.
It brings in maybe a more emotional, soft side to him. I wonder what song he could do, though, with the voice and style that he has. But that would be something very risky to do.
Yeah.
A new emotional soft side to Lane. I feel like we haven't seen that. It's been very upbeat.
You're right.
And
maybe that's what it is. He's been choosing really consistent, nice songs with the same exact rhythm and pace and emotion.
Yeah,
Yeah. And so if he were to choose a song, say, like Jeremiah, who sings very soulful from the heart, you know, that would be a good switch up.
Yeah, well, I mean, we do see it a little bit in this episode.
Later.
With the hero tributes later.
That's what I was going to bring up,
still, and, you know, without getting too far ahead of ourselves, I mean, that song is a little bit slower. I want to showcase it later. I do have it queued up. But I'm just trying to think of, you know, we see there's a bunch of people, like, you know, the first person that comes to mind, and it might just be a cop-out answer, is like Elvis. Elvis has so many rock hits, upbeat.
But he also has
the really soft, slow song, slow love songs. And I wonder if Lane could pull something like that off. I'd be very interested.
Uh-huh.
So that to me would be something, because I don't think it can be anything that he can do personality wise, you know, stage presence wise. It's going to have to come down to a surprising song choice, a risky song choice.
Yeah.
And if he can pull it off, that's when you know that he has that extra layer of depth to his artistry.
Right.
So, yeah. Still, great performance from Lane.
Yep.
Moving on. Let's see here on the list. So I have up next, we're going to move forward to the Elton John segment. Okay. I'm going to pull up from Madison Vandenberg singing Your Song by Elton John.
Now.
You say what you're going to say, and I'll probably say
the
same.
Okay. The songs that they gave Madison this episode have already been sung by previous contestants.
Which was weird.
Which is weird. She's the only contestant who's sung
outside
songs.
Of, like, audition to,
But that have already been sung by top 10.
Right, exactly.
Like, her Bobby's pick, Alyssa had already sung it.
Mm-hmm.
Her Elton... was sung by Walker.
Right.
And then her tribute was sung by Jeremiah.
Let me double check on what the tribute song was. It was Make You Feel My Love by Bob Dylan.
Yeah. So I don't know if Idol really picks it, or I don't know if they get first pick and then they have to go to Idol and then get it approved. I don't know how it works, but I just thought that was interesting.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, we were definitely talking about that when the show was going on. We were like, I feel like we've heard this before. And of course, we knew this song, Your Song, Elton John. But let's go ahead and take a listen at her take on this.
Sorry.
So first
just
off,
that camera. That just threw me off.
What happened
it just
there,
went,
guys?
Boom.
What happened, guys? I know it's live, but did you trip? Did you
possibly
just miss a step? I don't know.
Maybe.
All right, camera.
Did they
work
not
aside.
Switch it fast enough to the
camera
next
two, camera?
Camera
two. I said camera two, man. Anyways, before we get too carried away with the camera stuff,
right?
The performance. I mean, she does have such a strong voice. Her vocals are always so strong. But I thought interestingly that this performance was a little bit breathy.
Hmm.
And it kind of started, I feel like, at the beginning, from the start. And I don't know if it was like she just didn't get that initial deep breath, but it always felt like for this performance, she was trying to catch up on her breathing.
Yeah. Probably.
I don't know. But for me, though, it's like it's hard because having heard it one way, having
I just
hear,
got really sad when I just,
know.
You know, because it reminds
remember,
me of Walker.
I know.
Walker's gone.
He's gone. Well,
I mean,
kind of. We got some stuff. We got a little trailer to show a little bit later.
Right, but he's gone.
Out of the competition.
From the competition aspect, he's gone.
From the competition, he's gone. Overall, still
solid voice.
Yeah, still solid voice though. It's just it's hard, and I think that's unfortunate, just because it kind of. Comes
yeah
it's one of those things where similar to when you sing a song by an artist and it's an iconic song, it's hard to kind of match up to it. Now, mm-hmm. I'm not saying, it's just like the first memory that we have was
exactly.
Walker's, right?
So, yeah.
And we did love Walker, so mm-hmm. I don't know. Yeah, it's kind of, it kind of plays to a disadvantage for her, at least from us. I know people still loved the performance. I still, again, just from an objective standpoint, mm-hmm. think it was still pretty solid.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Speaking of iconic songs, up next I have Wade Coda performing
Rocket Man.
And again, we said this during the Queen episode, and I think the episode after?
Isn't this the one after the Queen episode?
Let me take a look at my notes here.
Michelle says yes.
So this was after the Queen episode?
Yeah.
And then what did he sing, though, the week before that I mentioned? He was getting all of the...
No. I think it's because they did multiple songs during the Queen episode.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Oh, right. So he got... Yeah, during the Queen night episode... that's right. Gotcha. Anyways, Wade, iconic
yes.
song.
Yeah.
Rocket Man.
Mm-hmm. Don't know if he chooses the songs or if American Idol goes, hey, you're doing this, but they give him some really strong known songs.
They give him the strong known songs and sometimes aren't necessarily the most suited for his style.
Voice. Yeah.
So let's take a listen and see how he does.
Mm.
So, like I said, a little bit of a tough song for his style. And, mm-hmm. I mean, I think with, for example, you go back to We Are the Champions.
Right.
Right?
Right.
And it's like you can kind of just belt that one out just almost in a screaming, singing fashion because it's such a power ballad.
Mm-hmm.
But this one has such a melody to it that kind of, in my opinion, needs to be a little bit followed.
Yeah.
To an extent.
Yeah, I see.
So it was a little bit tough.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, no discredit to him. Again, I'm not sure how he gets these songs because it doesn't seem like this is necessarily the best one for him. Whether it's like they pull something out of a hat, maybe, or something. But... unfortunately, out of the last iconic set of songs that he's done, in my opinion, this might have been the weakest.
I just don't think he felt as comfortable as he would have doing some other songs.
Sure. Yeah, definitely. So yeah.
But I thought it started out strong.
I do think so.
I did like the beginning.
Yeah, the smokiness to his voice, that just gravel raspiness fits that intro,
mm-hmm.
but when you get to that chorus, you really have to hit that chorus because this song is just so...
I also think he started to lose confidence in it and lost his commitment to the song halfway through when the chorus started happening, because even the judges said, with the glasses on, you don't need to take them off, you know, commit to the character, keep them on, stay in that Elton feel, don't fall out of it because you think, oh, they're probably judging me for having the glasses or I look silly, you know, just commit. So yeah, I think maybe this was a little leap out of his element.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Yeah, I agree. Definitely. But I, like you said, it started off fine,
mm-hmm.
but for me, just that chorus,
this
is such a known song, at least the chorus, you know?
Yeah. He could have, drawn out the notes.
Yeah.
A little
draw something,
more.
Something for sure. Let's see, who do we have next? I'm gonna pull up Alejandro. Sorry seems to be the hardest word. Now, I'm not sure, I didn't watch this one ahead of time, but I have been watching it throughout the week because I enjoyed it so much.
I've been going back and watching his performances from this night.
Yeah. Now the thing is on the American Idol YouTube channel, which by the way, if you want to see,
go ahead. Yeah.
If you want to see the full performances, of course, link in the description to the American Idol YouTube channel. Be sure to check out all these performances and any other we don't cover. I don't know if they did finally get around to re-uploading, but I don't think so.
I don't think so.
This video may have some weird skips happening.
I mean, you could go to Talent Recap. their YouTube channel has high quality
I'm too lazy
re-uploads.
Yeah,
I noticed that. I thought that was just my connection because I was driving up and down from LA and trying to listen to it, and then I was like, what just happened? Anyways, just you'll see.
Maybe we'll have to even cut it short afterwards so that way, you know, we got you. I just want to say that the first line chills to my core.
Mm-hmm.
And again, you'll notice him by himself, front man of the stage, and he's just so captivating.
Right.
The other thing too is it's such a emotionally backed song, and I can just feel I can feel every word.
There they
are just standing up.
Wow.
Luke had that face that he had from audition, not night one, but
trying to figure out a math problem face.
Yeah. Just this performance though, I was up on my feet clapping because I was just in awe of, like we said before, this felt like he was just truly trying, like, and that he wasn't always in the falsetto this time, which he normally I feel like is, you know, or in that higher register. He definitely had the range shifting, which I don't know. That's all I have to say about this, to be honest. It's just I loved it.
Yeah. And Luke even said, he said this twice now, I'm not worthy to critique you or to judge you. So now I will just cheer you on.
Yeah.
I will be your champion, man.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah.
Honestly.
Yeah.
So good. I have to keep saying it. This was my favorite. I will say this was my favorite performance of the night.
Yeah. Me as well.
Well.
Anyways.
That wraps up our segment on the Elton John portion of the performances. Up next, the Hero Tributes. This one will be kicked off by Lacey K. Booth. Now, this is going to be our first highlight of Lacey in this episode. So, she'll be performing Dreams by Fleetwood Mac. So,
I love Lacey's voice.
Yeah, it's so good. Such a fitting song. And the outfit, of course, the flower child. I mean, she just felt
flower child.
It was just very. This song was definitely, a great choice. But I just want to. I don't know why I want to just say it was like a very freeing performance for her. You know, she really had a great.
It was dedicated to her grandma.
Yeah, but it just had. It just really gave her a chance to shine, I think.
Mm-hmm. She has a very soothing voice. I feel like I say that every podcast, but
I mean,
it's okay. This isn't meant to be an insult, but I could sleep to her.
Sure.
To her singing.
I get what you mean by that. I get what you mean. Definitely.
Like she could sing me to sleep, and I could just go peacefully.
Sure. Sure. I guess.
I feel like I've also said that.
I think you've said this as well, but no, but it's true though. Like oh man, I don't know. It's just it's soothing. It's unique, and it was just a really, really good song choice. Definitely one that was important to at least bring out for this last portion of the last segment of songs.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely kind of like a good lasting memory kind of performance.
Mm-hmm.
What?
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
are we already going into the results
soon? I mean, here's the thing. I mean, we record this the night before the next episode airs,
so I would hope that by now
everybody knows the results.
But if you're following through this, we'll get to results.
We'll get to results. However, we will try better on our next set of series to make sure that these come out in a timely fashion.
Yeah, instead of right before the next episode. And
so
then,
now we have to recap from the week before. I understand something we're working on. It was kind of just a scheduling conflict that just
happened.
Ended up becoming a thing set in stone.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
We're working on it. We'll make our episodes more relevant.
Yeah.
Anything else you want to say about this performance by Lacey?
Beautiful.
Yeah, just beautiful overall. I agree. All right, up next for the hero tributes, Lane Hardy singing Hey Jude.
Oh.
By the Beatles.
Okay, wait. Back to Lacey real quick.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
So, I love when she sits and she has her guitar, or even if she's standing and she has the mic and she does the slower songs.
Oh, yes.
Because, was it her first performance of the night?
It was her...
Her Elton.
Yes, it was the Elton John that was a little bit faster, guitar. She was kind of performing more.
Mm-hmm.
I agree. I feel like we've said this before, too. I don't remember, but I think we've agreed, at least off the podcast, that she's more... it definitely seems like her style is more of a slower style. And when it comes to the faster ones, sometimes it's a little bit hard maybe for her to keep up, you know? But I agree. When she's sitting down with the guitar or she has the guitar and the microphone...
It's captivating.
It's almost like we were talking about with Alejandro, where they're the front of the stage and they can command the presence.
I agree.
Cool.
All right.
Back to it. Lane Hardy, Hey Jude by the Beatles.
This was dedicated to his brother.
Yes, it was.
His older brother.
And again, like we said earlier, this was what we were referring to when we mentioned, you know, maybe Lane takes a little bit of a different route with a more of a slower song. Let's take a listen. So it starts off slow.
Uh-huh.
But then it kind of has that build up again.
And then it gets back to his
kind of style.
Yeah.
Now, what if we have a song where it's just all slow, you know?
Uh-huh.
I'm always curious. I'm trying to think of a great song that he could do.
And Didn't he do one?
Did he?
I feel like
we'd have to go back through.
Yeah.
We'll have to go through the archives to find out. But I'm just saying... You know,
I want to see him attempt an emotional song.
That's what I mean. A more emotional, like love song or something. It definitely, you could feel it with Alejandro's and you could feel it with Lacey's. You know, this one, by the end of the song, you feel very uplifted. It starts off slow, then becomes very uplifting by the end. Upbeat tempo, like we said. So, yeah, I want a full on. Emotional, make me cry, Lane.
Yeah, make me cry.
Make me cry. And that would be that wow factor, I think, that we're looking for, that the judges are looking for, that they want from him.
Yeah.
Because I don't know.
Or something like that.
Something. But this was such a good performance from him.
Yeah.
This, again, is one of those, or at least I think, for me, was like, wow, he's singing it.
Mm-hmm.
He's
singing.
And... this again is, I feel like I've said it before, compliment to Lane, that no matter what song he sang throughout this competition, I haven't felt a falter in the vocal aspect.
Mm-mm.
You know,
it's the consistency,
always spot on vocally, but maybe it's because it's all the songs are perfectly in his range.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that's another thing. Maybe he has to take a risk and find new ranges to go towards and hit notes that we haven't heard before. That would be something interesting as well. But it definitely feels like, again, super solid performance, but just very consistent. Not a bad thing, but for the sake of the competition.
Mm-hmm.
So, oh boy. And he was just dressed so... He's always dressed so nicely.
I know. Wardrobe does him well.
Does very well with him. And then in the other performance earlier, his guitar was sick.
Yeah.
Super sick.
Yeah. So, wait, was it this episode or was it a past episode that he was wearing like $4,000 shoes or something of that
number? With the diamond in it?
Yeah.
I forget.
He was wearing really expensive shoes. I don't know if it was $4,000 or
something. Very expensive shoes.
Something
with a diamond
in the K range.
Oh, yeah. In the Ks.
Very expensive shoes.
Oh, yeah.
doesn't get to keep them, though. Unfortunately.
That'd be crazy. Maybe if you win it, maybe you get to keep it or something.
Just, hey, here's...
I don't need my...
They give him the money right there. He's like, here's a few thousand
here,
dollars.
Take it back. I want the
shoes. I'll take the shoes. I'll take my whole wardrobe on the season.
Keep the money.
And the guitar.
I want the shoes.
Yeah.
All right. Last performance that I have listed, Alejandro.
Of course. We've shown all three of his songs.
Yes, we have.
Yeah.
We've also shown all three of Lane's.
Have we?
Oh, no. No, we haven't.
We didn't show his Elton.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. That's right. But we've shown all three of Alejandro.
Yeah.
Well, there's a reason. I like Alejandro.
Yeah.
Well,
he was just very strong this episode.
Very.
Yeah.
Very.
We can say he wasn't so strong in the last couple episodes. I mean, maybe not last episode, but the few episodes before that, you know?
Yes. Yes.
But this episode, he had really strong performances, and that is why we are showcasing all of them.
Again, I just feel like he showed up.
Yeah, he showed up.
You showed up. I wish we had like a GIF of that. To just put up.
I know how to make GIFs. I can do okay. It.
Is it GIF or JIF? You tell us in the comments. Sorry. It came to my head.
It's fine.
All right. This is Alejandro performing his original song, Blesser. Odd that it's part of the hero tribute section, but I think it's just...
No. It's because he was dedicating it to his mentor, who helped develop his style and helped develop... You know,
oh, you're right. I remember
him
now.
As an artist. And so I guess that influences in this song, perhaps. I don't know.
Sure.
I don't know.
We've been talking about this song being performed for a while, though.
Everyone has. Everyone wanted
even the comments from like way back when the show was just beginning.
But they wanted this for the finale.
True.
So I wonder what he's going to do for the finale.
We'll have to stay tuned and find out.
I think I might know. Or I might not know.
Well, let's put our predictions in after. Let's take a listen to Blesser.
My only comment is I think the backup singer is kind of distracted from the performance.
I agree. I kind of honestly want to pull up
the original. Please do. Please do.
Yeah, just to...
Fun fact, I listen to this before I go into auditions to calm down my nerves and to kind of meditate. It puts me in a really weird... higher self state where I can just kind of quiet my thoughts and just have a completely clear mind.
It's interesting because of the just that I feel like I know what you're talking about.
Because you're just so focused. It really just brings an awareness to this weird concentrative focus point where all you really listen to are the notes and the piano and then his vocals and everything. It's just so I can't explain it. It's magical.
So I think for me, it's like not the arpeggio part, but that intro where it's going so fast. It's almost like your mind is racing, but in a focused manner.
In a focused manner, but it's like, I don't know how to explain it.
Like that, those notes in that succession, the way it's the staccato and the tempo of it, it's just like, it jumbles your brain to the point of focus.
Exactly.
And there's nothing else for you to think about but what you're hearing.
That's
and
what I was trying to explain to mom, which is why I listened to it before auditions, because it's not that it's at a nice pace where it doesn't make me anxious, but it gets my brain going.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Again, the best way that I can describe it, that intro section is very creatively organized chaos.
Yeah,
the notes feel
chaos.
Very disconnected, disjointed, and yet they create this really coherent melody.
Yeah, I guess the feeling that I feel when I hear it is excitement.
Yeah, and that's a good way to put it.
A nice built up of excitement.
Yeah.
Anyways, go ahead.
Let me see if I can pull this up here.
Can you up it? Thank you.
I don't care about the truth. Oh man, I mean, so this is the original upload of this performance. I agree. I think if it was more just solely him,
I don't even think he needed the background.
No,
whoever.
I think he didn't. The other thing I'm actually curious to maybe go back and look at.
He simplified it.
He does simplify it, yes, but I'm wondering if I want to take a long look at the piano. He has that one B-roll footage on the American Idol YouTube channel where he mentions that the audition piano was a digital piano.
Mm. So and, do you think because...
And if you listen...
Do you think maybe there aren't enough keys on it to the
no,
point
No, that's
where-
not what I... What I was going for was more of the... When you listen to this with the acoustics of the room, there's this fullness of the piano. It's very... I mean, it's not a grand piano, but there's this grand... sound, this fullness to the piano part that really takes over in this song. Mm-hmm. And it just felt a little bit dampened.
I was gonna say, the first time I heard the one on Idol, I thought the piano sounded really muted.
Muted is a better word. That's the one I was looking for.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's all I mean. And it's hard to say whether or not it is digital or not, but I just know that in his audition, he did mention that it was a digital piano and if it was a little bit different for him, but still, I mean,
this is still amazing.
It's
insane.
Is. Yeah.
But for those who religiously listened to the original, it was just like, oh, we loved it.
But
the background singers, and then maybe I don't know, the piano
a
bit.
People are a lot more nitpicky with this, I think, because of the expectation that was set from the video, from the original, and all the hype that was built up around, we want this song, and we have this expectation of what it should be. I don't think it necessarily met up to those expectations. But still, just the genius of this piece is still something to be said.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I thought as well. I definitely think
nonetheless he's still a genius.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
100% agree. Crazy though. Crazy. Yeah. Crazy good on the piano. Whew. Insane. Well, that's all the performances that I have listed that I wanted to showcase. Let's move into the results.
Right.
So the top three for the finale for tomorrow night's episode competing to be winner of American Idol Season 2. The contestants are Madison Vandenberg, Alejandro Aranda, Lane Hardy. Now, I want to quickly show the little trailer that they have posted up on the American Idol YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
Just because I do think it's pretty cool. We'll see. Well, let's just take a look.
This is your American Idol finale lineup. Adam Lambert with Demetrius Graham. Dan and Shay with Madison Vandenberg. Get ready to party with a Hardy. John Party with Lane Hardy. Kane Brown with Alyssa Ragu. Cool in the Gang with Uche, Weezer with Wade Coda and Walker Burrows, and a not-to-be-missed performance from Alejandro Aranda. Plus, Montel Jordan takes the stage with some of the season's most viral contestants. And the top 40 favorite, Shay, performs with a Grammy-nominated surprise guest, featuring special performances by the American Idol judges, Luke Bryan with Lacey K. Booth, Lionel Richie with the top 10, and Katy Perry with Jeremiah Lloyd Harmon. And making her return to the Idol stage, Carrie Underwood. Don't miss the one-night American Idol Grand Finale, Sunday, May 19th, live coast-to-coast on ABC.
So, be sure you guys tune into that. It's going to be pretty exciting. That's really cool that they're bringing people back.
Yeah, did they do that last season?
No.
Well then, oh really?
I don't know.
Okay. Okay. But yeah, I think that's really cool that they bring everyone back, or top 10 at least, and then people who didn't make top 10, who didn't even make top 20.
Yeah, I mean, like,
I'm surprised they're not bringing people from top 20 though.
Yeah. It's interesting. It's funny though that they have that section a little bit about the viral viral favorites or whatever. I think that's gonna be, I don't know, it's gonna be really cool regardless to see a bunch of people back. Of course, with only three contestants, you gotta kinda fill the time. So I kinda,
it's true.
I totally understand. But it hopefully will make for a very entertaining show. Walker's back,
but he doesn't get his own.
I know. I kind
of duet. Yeah. He has to share it with Wade.
Weezer, Wade, and Walker. That'll be interesting to see.
3W.
I didn't even notice that until right now.
Because the way you said it, it was Weezer, Wade, and Walker.
Yeah. Yeah. What are you doing? You guys want to see that trailer again? Be sure to check the link in the description to the American Idol YouTube channel. Again, all other performances that we may have missed, as well as performances from this past season.
Yes.
Okay. Here's something I want to talk about. Let's talk about the results, though.
Okay. The results.
Does the conspiracy hold true for the results for this finale?
Are you talking about them taking first, and then the bottom, and then the middle?
Well, I'm just looking at it from, you take the top two, you know.
Yeah.
And then you add one of the bottom of the follow counts. And again, we've already discredited the idea of follow counts being a valid argument, mm-hmm. but it's just a very interesting thing.
Yeah.
You keep or at least the idea of keeping around one of the, you could think of it as like lower seed contestants. For the underdog kind of role.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely interesting. Again, just based on follow counts of Lane and Alejandro's following is just so strong and fairly large compared to the lower end of the contestants' follow counts. So I don't know. It somewhat does. The other thing that's interesting is you look at kind of the, audience reaction on Twitter to seeing Lacey go. Everybody was pretty sad about that and a little bit confused in that aspect. So it's like you look at your top three just based on fan favorite would be Alejandro, Lane, Lacey, which is something that we've been saying for the past couple of weeks now.
Yeah.
And so to see Lacey go, you know, stirs up a little bit of discussion.
But she did get quote unquote cut. Last episode.
True.
So people
to get
could
saved, right?
Yeah.
Right. That is a valid point. I don't know. Very interesting though.
But if we're going based off of our conspiracy theory, then
she should never have been in that position to begin
with. Exactly.
Well, the conspiracy theory would prove that, yes, that's the position she would be in to have to be in that section. But based on fan following, it wouldn't have made sense.
Exactly.
So what I do want to talk about real quick is kind of a little bit of a throwback to our first episode where we, in our first episode, tried to predict who
was going to be the next American Idol.
Oh my goodness. Look at that. This is from episode one. Fire and Rice.
Our lighting looks better.
Now?
No, here.
There. I know. What's up with that?
I don't know.
But look at this just... this just poor sign is just on a box on the ground. I mean, I'm not saying that we've like gotten a little bit better, but I'd like to think that we look a little bit better than just two people sitting in front of a camera.
Yeah.
slowly but surely we'll make this a pretty nice looking thing.
No, no, don't worry, guys. Don't worry.
I mean, just look at the difference between this and the first episode. But anyways, before we get too carried away, episode one, around this area is where we talk a little bit about our predictions. So let's take a listen to what we thought. Going back to, I just kind of want to go back to the whole, like, who will be American Idol?
Well, who do you think? I said my 2 cents.
Well, I said not Alejandro.
Yes.
I think it could easily be Walker Burrows as well. Like you said, he's very...
Yeah, Katie said that he could win it if he just dresses like Harry Potter and sings like that.
Yeah, no, that
and was, then he could win.
So. Yeah, I think Walker
I don't know why we both picked Walker to win.
We done goofed.
And I said, not Alejandro. But who is this guy?
But we said...
Who is this? Were you not listening?
But you... Okay. But didn't you say not Alejandro just because of some miraculous reason? It wasn't because you didn't believe in him as an artist to win it.
So if I remember correctly from the episode, I said... Not Alejandro because it's the obvious choice.
Yeah.
Because he is so clearly talented off of the just first audition.
Exactly.
That it was the obvious choice at the time. As the seasons progressed, a lot of great competition just really stepped up. And, I mean, it made for a really, really good show. Exactly. I'm really sad that this is going to end because this was such...
This is a great season of reality competition TV.
Absolutely. The best. Yeah. Like, super talented group.
I can honestly say that.
Yeah.
I don't think I've ever watched a show or even been a part of a show where it felt like, wow, this is so great because it could literally be anyone's game. It doesn't feel like it's that cohorted by the scenes.
We're all coming to full circle here. Cohorting. You guys have no idea what we're talking about. Be sure to check
out. If you haven't watched the first episode, if you have watched the first episode, you would know
of the cohorting that has been going on
that goes on behind the scenes
in this show on our series. Well, I wanted to just bring that up because I thought it was a very interesting and a little bit of a sad throwback.
Yeah.
As we're nearing the end of our series here with American Idol. So I think the last thing that we really have to mention is just who do we think is going to win? I definitely think that these three, though, do have a really strong storyline.
Yes.
Now, here's something that I want maybe a fact check on. Let's talk about the three contestants that are left and kind of what they bring to the table. Madison... If she wins, is she the youngest contestant to have won American Idol? That's my first thing. And if that is going to be the case, that would be a great headlining story point.
Mm-hmm.
Again, we're going to get some fact checking on that.
Yeah.
You have Alejandro, right? This just extremely out of the blue, random, busking
genius.
Like,
give him that push start.
Right. And all he needed was... It's one of those stories of...
He represents... literally anybody can do it.
That's my point. He represents the untapped talent and potential out there that is so greatly out there. I believe that...
And all it takes is hard work.
Hard work or just that little bit of exposure to really blow up.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And then, of course, you have Lane, who's the comeback kid.
Also a great story.
Exactly.
That's an amazing story.
That's what I'm saying.
Here's the thing with these stories. If these people hadn't made the decision in their life at some point to go, I'm going to audition for American Idol today, their lives would not be where they are now.
Agreed.
And their careers would not be where they are now.
Agreed.
I mean, if Lane had turned them down, this season because he turned
on night one, or, yeah, or he, audition one, whatever.
Yeah, they offered him to come back.
Yeah, he wasn't planning.
He wasn't going to, and then he showed up at his friend's audition to help out, and then they said, "Hey, we'll give you a ticket if you want to come back. You can come back, but just sing us something." And he did, and he almost didn't take it, but he did. So he could have not made it this far.
And now he's top. He's in the finale. Three. And just the idea of, like, what if he's not in it? Does that change the dynamic of the show? Does that that obviously changes who makes it through and who doesn't? But, like, that changes a ton of voting metrics. Like, it's crazy.
And then Alejandro, if he decided not to go in that day and audition, he would not be where he is right now either. It's just crazy. I feel like he kind of also represents the, I guess the person who wouldn't necessarily audition in the first place.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I haven't really been watching the show, but I feel like people like him would probably not want to audition for the show. Sure. They come from kind of a, oh, you know, TV, not my thing.
The more chill, introverted, exactly. Kind of like, yeah.
Yeah, more, he was an more introvert.
Those that shy away from attention.
Exactly.
Like him. Like, yeah. We've seen multiple instances of, you know, in his Instagram or whatever, the, you know, it's definitely something very new, something very much out of his comfort zone.
Very.
But yeah, like I said, the storylines for these three, do we know if, okay. Interesting. So
only
we have
by 8 months.
Yeah, coming
Wait,
in.
Who was it?
Okay, so got.
Okay. How old was he?
Okay, got so interesting. We got word that if she does win, she will be the youngest winner to date. So, like I said, just really cool headlines, really cool stories across the board from these three.
Yeah.
So I definitely think that's, in my opinion, whoever wins, it's really good for them.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, whoever wins, extremely good for them. Now, the big question, who do we think is going to take it all?
I don't know. It keeps changing for me. Because I keep thinking, oh, so-and-so is going to win. And then I think, no, they're not because of this reason. And then so-and-so is going to win. No, they're not because of this reason. I think Lane, once again, has the most following from American Idol. So I think he's going to win.
Sure.
Alejandro, however, especially in recent episodes, has been getting a lot of endorsement from the judges.
Yeah.
You know? So that might push for the votes, but also, okay, here's my thing. With Lane, I have never seen a comment on any sort of American Idol platform or on his page saying he shouldn't be where he is. I've seen comments of people saying Alejandro should not be in the top three, or wow. Alejandro should not be in top five, or Alejandro should not be in top six.
I have seen that. No, I actually will say that I've seen some, I guess you could call it like Photoshop memes or whatever, of mm-hmm. people saying, and this is your top, whatever. And then they would Photoshop Lane's face out and put like Walker on top or like whoever. So-and-so that got voted off on top of his body. So I can say that I've seen people that have said maybe that Lane, they didn't want Lane to go
really?
Through.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
So I get what you're saying though. It does feel like maybe Lane's is maybe less than others compared to at least the other two finalists.
Yeah.
But I will agree with you. I do think that Lane has the best chance at winning, the highest percentage of winning, just based off of the American Idol following. He's been on for two seasons.
Mm. Comeback story.
The comeback story. But just, I think that his style is very well-rounded and easy to listen to.
Yeah.
It's like a style that
for all of America,
all of people can really get behind.
Yeah.
Whereas Alejandro's a little bit more experimental, so sometimes it's hit, you know, it's
hit or miss because he is taking those chances and
but
risks.
He is
it's not as consistent.
It isn't.
But we do see a lot of really great, outstanding performances.
Yeah. When it's great, it's amazing. And when it's not so great, it's like, okay, you tried.
But we still love you because you're a genius.
But when you look at it from that perspective, too, of being very experimental, it's like, I think they've said it, that he could change the game of music, which would be very big, too.
Mm-hmm. And then so, Madison.
She's just such a powerhouse vocalist that, like...
I haven't seen any comments, though, of her, of people saying that she shouldn't be where she is. Have you?
See, now I'm trying to think, and I do also feel like it's not as many, but I maybe have seen some, but it's still pretty low.
No, it's still pretty low. It's because, pretty low. I think also she has that very...
relatable?
I was about to say relatable sound that all of America can listen to. The young pop artist sound.
Yeah, very relatable. Young pop artist, very young, very inspiring to the kids. So again, like we just mentioned, it's like all of them have such great stories to back why they should win.
Yeah.
So I'm just excited to see who's really going to take it all, because this is, we've said it over and over, this was such a great competition, such a talented group of competitors, and yeah, I'm really just excited to see tomorrow's episode.
Yeah.
So, man, it's crazy. Well, that's all that I had. I think we're a little bit over our usual time. So, if you guys did enjoy, though, please be sure to like, comment down below.
And subscribe.
Yes, definitely. Like, yes. Comment, subscribe. Comment down below if there's any other shows you want us to cover in the future. Like we said, we'll be continuing. As we close out American Idol, we'll also be picking up Bachelorette. So be sure to go through the channel, check out episode 7 to see that first episode of the Bachelorette recap. Oh, man. Let us know in the comments.
Yeah.
Who's going to win it all?
Yep.
Let us know.
I know. Oh, it ends tomorrow.
I know.
That's so crazy.
It's crazy. But be sure to look out for the next episode of our Bachelorette recap, as well as our finale recap for American Idol. Yep.
And follow us on Instagram.
Yes, we do have official Fire and Rice podcast social media. So we got Twitter down here, Fire Rice podcast.
And then Instagram is Fire and Rice podcast. I run the Instagram, you run the Twitter. We'll be posting content soon. Look out for that. Cool. And we have new banners, thanks to Michelle Welly.
Yes, new banners.
Yes.
New stuff all around.
New stuff.
We're
new
really
content.
Trying to expand, so be sure to follow us on those. We'd really appreciate it.
Yeah.
With that being said, thanks for watching this episode. Hope you have a good one, and we'll see you in the next one. Peace.
Deuces.